So every year in the US, approximately 36,000 Americans die by suicide. To give you a better understanding of how many people that actually is, imagine the entire OSU campus being wiped out by suicide. This is how many lives are lost each year because of suicide. And something you may not know is that American Indians and Alaska Natives have higher suicide rates than other groups in the US. And it's through research specifically identifying these risk and protective factors that we can better understand why this health disparity continues to occur. So to give you just a few statistics about American Indian and Alaska Native suicide, the suicide death rates for American Indians and Alaska Natives is 82% higher than other racial or ethnic groups in the US. For Native males ages 15 to 24, the suicide death rate is more than 2 times the rate for same-age males of all ethnicities. And for Native females ages 15 to 24, the suicide death rate is nearly 3 times the rate for same-age females of all ethnicities. So you can see how big of a problem this really is. So in addition to these national statistics, I want to provide you with one personal story. So in the summer of 2009, I was a part of a program here at OSU called American Indians in Psychology. Shout out to Dr. Cheney in the audience. He's the director of this amazing program. And as a part of this program, I was working for a behavioral health facility for one tribe. And I was sitting in the waiting room one day reading some articles. And a Native client walked in and he said, "Hey, what are you reading there?" And I said, "I'm reading about Native suicide." He then proceeded to tell me how he had recently lost a family member to suicide. And then he said, "There isn't one person around here who hasn't had a family member or friend kill themselves." And this statement really stuck with me. I've never forgotten what that client said to me. So what I'm here to tell you today is that losing a family member or friend to suicide should not be a common reality of Native people and communities. And this is really the reason that I'm committed to better understanding Native suicide through research. So there's some resistance and mistrust of researchers by Native communities, so it's my hope that as a Native woman and researcher, I can help be an advocate to really stop this tragedy from continuing to affect our communities. There's very little past research on Native suicide, so it means we really don't understand why this health disparity continues to occur. Past research has identified some risk factors, including historical trauma. So this is the intergenerational loss of American Indian, Alaska Native people, land, and culture due to colonization beginning in 1492 that continues to affect Native families and communities. Another risk factor identified in past research is psychological disorders, including depression and substance use disorders. There's also been some resiliency factors identified in past research, including positive mood, spirituality, and social support. So through my research, I'm hoping to start filling in the gaps and try and identify more risk and protective factors for suicide, specifically for Native people. So in one study I did, I wanted to see whether a well-known theory called the interpersonal psychological theory of suicide can help explain Native suicide risk. According to this theory, individuals who die by suicide have higher levels of thwarted belongingness, so this is feeling as if you don't belong to your family, your friends, the community, as well as you don't feel like you're cared about. And at the same time, these individuals have higher levels of perceived burdensomeness, so this is feeling like you're ineffective, feeling like you're not capable, and feeling like you're a burden on your friends, your family, the community, or even the larger society level. So in my study, I had 172 American Indian Alaska Natives representing 28 different tribes participate in my study. And what I found was that simultaneously higher levels of thwarted belongingness and perceived burdensomeness was related to higher levels of suicidal thinking. So giving some initial support for using this well-known theory of suicide to help explain American Indian suicide risk. Another study I did focused on resiliency or protective factors against suicide. So I wanted to see whether hope and optimism, which are two variables from the field of positive psychology, can help protect against suicidal thinking. So in this study, I had 168 American Indian Alaska Native participants from 27 different tribes participate. And what I found was that higher levels of both hope and optimism was related to lower levels of suicidal thinking. So again, giving some support that these two variables, hope and optimism, may protect against suicidal thinking for Native people. So I'm going to continue to do my research, identifying more risk and protective factors for Native suicide. And it's my hope that this research is used to help inform culturally appropriate prevention and treatment programs for Native communities. And through all of this, I'm really hoping to see a decrease in American Indian, Alaska Native suicide rates and really stop this tragedy from continuing to be a shared experience for Native people. Thank you.